So today we are going to discuss about gyroscopic effect on four-wheeled vehicles. That's what we are going to discuss today. So this is a four-wheeled vehicle. It is taking a left turn. It has four wheels, engine, and so when it is taking left turn, the centrifugal force is acting towards outward. And the mass of the vehicle is acting in downward direction. So now, the centrifugal force. What is the equation to find the centrifugal force? Fc is equal to mass of the vehicle into velocity squared divided by r. That is the centrifugal force equation. Because it is taking a turn, it is moving with velocity r, and the radius of the curve is r. So the centrifugal force will be mv square r. This will be acting towards outside. And mass into gravity, that is the weight which is acting. So here if you take this distance is 2.5, it is acting at a 1 meter length. This is 2.5 meters, this 1.5 meter it is acting. So the upper front wheel will be subjected to more load than the back wheels. If it is exactly the center, all will be subjected to equal load, but it is not, so it is. So that another, here we have a force, here we have a centrifugal force. Addition to that, this wheel is rotating while it is taking a left turn. So this will be subjected to gyroscopic effect. So some couple is produced. When you view from this direction, it is rotating in counterclockwise direction. So you can keep the hand like this. Now it is taking a left turn. It is taking a left turn. When it is taking a left turn, see here the active gyroscopic uphill direction is this. We want reactive, so it will be like this. So this is a gyroscopic uphill of the wheel. So what will be the value? Gyroscopic uphill of the wheel, Cw, we can take Iw, Ww into Wb. So this is angular velocity of rotation. If you know the n, the speed at which the wheel is rotating, we can find Ww. That is omega W, angular velocity of wheel. Iw is equal to moment of inertia of the wheel. Omega p is equal to what? Omega p is the angular velocity of precision. That we know the equation, omega p is equal to v by r. By using the equation v by r, we can calculate the angular velocity of precision. So that will create a couple. So this will be the couple. Similarly, this engine is rotating when you view from the clockwise direction. And it's taking a left turn. The vehicle is taking a left turn. That also will create a gyroscopic couple. So now this is rotating in. When you viewed from this direction, it is rotating in clockwise direction. You can keep the hand like this. You can keep the hand like this. And it is taking a left turn. It is a left turn. So it is taking. So the this will be the position of the hand. Now you see the fingers. It is in this direction. So this is active gyroscopic couple. The opposite will be the reactive. So now okay, so here it is taking a left turn. It is taking a left turn. So in this case, the reactive gyroscopic couple direction will be this. This will be the reactive gyroscopic couple direction. And from this that also will create a couple. So now in the vehicle, there are number of couples are acting. So yes, centrifugal force, it will create a couple. The force into this is center of gravity of the vehicle height. So force into height will create a couple. This will create one couple. This couple will be acting between the, this is inner wheel, this is outer wheel. Between inner and outer wheel, it will act. So it will create force on the inner wheel and outer wheel. Similarly, this couple. So that also will create a couple. So at the outer wheel, forces will be created. Inner wheel also force will be created. Now you see this couple. This is due to the engine. This couple, what is the equation to find the couple due to the engine? That is CE is equal to IE, moment of inertia of the engine, into angular velocity of the engine and precision. Omega B, the same value. The same value you can take. Omega E. So there is a gear ratio that is called omega E divided by omega omega. If you know this value, you can find the value of omega e multiplying with g. So omega e is equal to g into omega b. You can calculate. So if we can calculate, we have to calculate omega w, that is omega w b. So how it can be calculated is, we know the velocity of the vehicle. We know the velocity of the vehicle. There is a relation between the velocity of the vehicle and angular velocity of this wheel. So the velocity at the outermost radius of this wheel will be equal to v. The velocity, the tangential velocity of the wheel at the outermost radius will be equal to v. So we can write what is a, this is the angular velocity. Angular velocity in the radius. What radius? Radius of the wheel. That will be equal to velocity of the vehicle. From this, we can calculate the value of omega w, that is angular velocity of the wheel. So by using this, you will be able to calculate the forces. Now, this couple and this couple is acting between the inner cylinder and outer cylinder. And this force and this couple will be acting between the front and back wheel. What are the forces acting? Forces and couples, weight of the vehicle, centrifugal force, and reactive gyroscopic couple due to engine and wheel. Now, the centrifugal force can be calculated with this, using this equation, and coupled due to wheel can be calculated using this equation. Here there are four wheels, so we use four, and this is gyroscopic couple due to engine. So now, this is the inner wheel. This is the inner wheel, this is the outer wheel. Here, this is a gyroscopic couple due to the wheel, and this is a centrifugal force. So now, if you take moment about this point, we know this value and this value. And what is the reaction at the inner wheel? That we can calculate. Inner wheel, we can calculate. So due to this, there will be a reaction at inner wheels and outer wheels. If you take moment about this point, you can calculate this. Similarly, if you take moment about this point, we can calculate the reaction at the outer wheel. So this is due to gyroscopic couple of the wheel and centrifugal force. Similarly, between the front wheel and back wheel, we have to find the reactions. That is due to gyroscopic couple due to engine and the weight of the vehicle. So if you take moment about this point, you can calculate the reaction at the rear wheels. You can calculate. Similarly, we can calculate the reaction at the front wheel if you take moment about this point. So always we take here, we take 2RR, the reaction at that, because when you view from this direction, there will be two rear wheels and two outer wheels. So the RF is equal to reaction at one wheel. There are two wheels, we are taking at one wheel. So now you can refer the diagram. If you see this diagram, when the couple is acting, so we are calculating force between the front wheel and back wheel. So here there are two wheels. So for one wheel, we can take RR. So for two wheels, 2RR, that we have to take. That's what. Similarly, 2RF, front wheel, so that you have to take. So that's what given here. He say here 2RR. 2RF means there are two front wheels. So for one front wheel, that is RF. For one rear wheel, RR. So we can calculate reaction. Here we can calculate the reactions. Here we can calculate the reaction. So our objective is to calculate the net force acting in each wheel. If any one of the wheel is at very high velocity, sometimes at one wheel, the force acting reaction at the wheel may be upward direction. If it is upward direction, it will topple the vehicle. So why you are calculating the reactions? All the reactions must be in downward direction. Then only the vehicle will be stable. The vehicle will not be stable, or it will be toppled when the reaction is upward direction. If any one of the wheel is subject to upward force, the vehicle will be toppled. Now, so we'll discuss one problem. Now, a four-wheeled car has a total mass of 300 kg. The mass of the vehicle is equal to 3,000 kg. Each wheel is 450 mm radius. The wheel radius, wheel is like this. each wheel is 450 mm radius. Wheel radius we taken as small r. The center distance between the two wheel on axle is 1.5 meter and wheel base is 2.5 meter. The height of center of gravity is 0.5 meter above the road surface and located at 1 meter from the front axle. Each wheel has moment of inertia of 32. So wheel moment of inertia IW is equal to 32 kg meter square. And the engine axis is along the longitudinal axis of the vehicle. The engine rotates four times the speed of the wheel. That is G. That is angular velocity of engine divided by angular velocity of the wheel is equal to G. That is equal to 4. Engine rotates four times the speed of the wheel in clockwise direction when viewed from the front. The mass of the rotating part is 70 kg. Having radius of gyration is 100. The mass of the rotating part of engine. So, if you want to calculate I of the engine, that is 70 kg, 70 mass into radius of gyration square. This is millimeter. So, you put in meter. So, this will be the IE. If the car is taking a turn 70 mm radius, radius is 70 mm and the velocity is 50. So, from that, what you can calculate? We can calculate angular velocity of precision that we can calculate, that is 50 kilometer velocity by radius. If you put this, velocity is equal to 50. So 50 into 1000, that is kilometer into meter, divided by 3600 hour into second, divided by 70. So this will give omega p. Find the ground reactions. You have to find the reaction. What is the reaction at each wheel? So now, if I omega we know, omega B is known, omega W how to calculate? I told this can be calculated by velocity divided by R. So the velocity, the tangent velocity of the tire is equal to the velocity of the vehicle. So omega into R, omega W into R. So from this we can calculate the angular velocity of the wheel, that is 50 into 1000 divided by 3600 multiplied by radius of the wheel. What is the radius of the wheel? It is 450 millimeters, so 0.45 meters. So this will give, so now we have the value of mass of the vehicle is there, moment of inertia of the wheel is there, omega W, the angular velocity of wheel is there, omega B is there. We can calculate the value of C wheel. We can calculate. That is equal to I W into omega W into omega P. So we can calculate. Similarly, C engine is equal to, so four times, you have to put four times because four wheels, you have to put four. C is equal to I E into omega E into omega P. So here omega E is equal to, here it is four times G. So omega E, that is four times G times omega W. So this you can replace by G into omega W. We have omega W, I E, omega P. Everything is there. We can calculate this. So by using this, already we know the equation for centrifugal force, Fc is equal to mv square by R. We can calculate this, and the weight is given. So we know all couples forces. So now we can calculate the reaction at wheel. So all the dimensions are given. So this is a way it is, the forces couples are acting. And this is the weight of the vehicle. This is acting here. And omega W, that is angular velocity of the wheel, V by small r, this is radius of the wheel. We calculated this. Omega P, that is V by capital R. We can calculate this omega P. Centrifugal force, we have, this is centrifugal force. The, where it is acting? It is acting here, centrifugal force. And CW, that is couple due to the wheel. So this will be the value. What is the direction of couple due to the wheel? Couple due to the wheel is this. This is a couple due to wheel. And coupled due to engine. Coupled due to engine. So this is the value. What is the direction? It is acting here. It is acting here. So now, when you see from this direction, when you see from this direction, the mass you take and this couple. So these are acting between the inner and outer wheel. Inner and outer wheel. Now, see. So this is okay. So this is now, if you see from the front, if you see from the front, this is inner wheel, this is outer wheel, because it is taking a turn like this. So this will be the inner wheel, this will be the outer wheel. So between inner and outer wheel, this couple is acting. This couple is acting and centrifugal force is acting, right? Now you take this, see, this is a outer wheel, this is an inner wheel. Two outer wheels we are taking, two inner wheels we are taking. Why? Because this couple is acting between, here there are two inner wheels, here there are two outer wheels. So the for one wheel, it is R naught. So these are the reactions, and this is a couple. This value we know, this value we know. So now you take moment about this point. If you take moment about this point, we can calculate the value of Ri. We can calculate the, so taking moment about inner wheel, outer wheel, we can find the value of Ri. Similarly, if you take moment about this point, if you take moment about this point, you can find the value of R naught. Now we have calculated the R naught. Ri is calculated, R naught is calculated. Now you come to the next one. This is between the rear wheel and front wheel. So this is aeroscopic coupled due to engine. This is the mass of the vehicle. So now if you resolve this, now if you take moment about this point, you can find the value of Rr. If you take moment about this point, you can find the value of Rf. Here also two Rr we are taking, because two front wheel, two rear wheel. So you can find the value of Rr, Rf. After that, so now we have calculated all the forces, reaction acting in the each wheel. Now we are taking this A, wheel A, wheel B, wheel C, and wheel D. Each wheel, what is the net force acting? That you have to calculate. Net force acting, we have to calculate. So now, the net force acting on each wheel is calculated. So this is a net force acting on wheel A. This is B, this is C, this is D. Out of which, the reaction at A is maximum. The wheel A is subjected to more force. The B and C are medium, and D is subjected to very less force. If any one of the forces is negative, then the forces, it means the force is acting in the upward direction. The vehicle will be toppled. Vehicle will be toppled. So now, when you see this diagram, when you see this diagram, so the wheel A is subjected to more force. When the vehicle is taking left turn, the wheel A is subjected to more load. And B and C are subjected to equal load. D is subjected to the less load. This is the loads are because of what? Weight of the vehicle, centrifugal force, coupled due to the wheel, gyroscopic coupled due to the wheel, gyroscopic coupled due to the engine. All together, A is subjected to maximum load, and D is subjected to minimal load. B and C are equal, are subjected to intermediate load. So this is the gyroscopic couple, and it affects on a four-wheeled vehicle.